Hello, good afternoon. Today's topic is P block elements, group 15th family, unit 4. In the previous class, we discussed about the anomalous behavior of nitrogen, reactivity of 15th group elements towards hydrogen, trends in thermal stability, melting points, boiling points, reducing nature, Lewis basic character, and reactivity towards oxygen, that is nature of oxides, whether they are acidic or basic, reactivity towards halogen, nature of halides, whether they are ionic or covalent. Reactions of group 15th elements. Nitrogen combines with magnesium at high temperature, we get magnesium nitride. Phosphorus combines with calcium to form calcium phosphide. Sodium combines with arsenic and sodium arsenide is resulted. Zinc combines with antimony, zinc antimonide we get. Magnesium combines with bismuth, we get magnesium bismuthide. In all these compounds, the general formula is either E3H. Preparation of nitrogen in laboratory. In laboratory preparation, a mixture of ammonium chloride and sodium nitrite in aqueous solutions are mixed and heated, we get nitrogen gas. The so prepared nitrogen gas has impurities of nitric oxide and nitric acid. The impurities can be removed by passing the gas, that is nitrogen gas, along with the impurities through concentrated sulfuric acid. And nitric oxide and nitric acid are absorbed, hence we get pure nitrogen gas. Production of nitrogen from air, that is liquefaction of air. Air has oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, inert gases, dust particles. So the mixture of air is passed through filters. When air is passed through filters, dust is removed. Dust-free air has oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, inert gases. This dust-free air is cooled and compressed. As dust-free air is cooled and compressed, carbon dioxide is liquefied and is removed. The leftover air has oxygen, nitrogen, and inert gases. Leftover air is cooled and compressed to large extent. Then air gets liquefied. As air gets liquefied, oxygen becomes liquid and it is removed. Leftover air has only nitrogen and traces of inert gases. Inert gases do not affect the activity of nitrogen. Now let us see the physical properties of nitrogen. Nitrogen is colorless, odorless, and tasteless gas. It has a very low solubility. Only 22.3 centimeter cube of nitrogen dissolves in 1 liter of water. Melting point is 63 Kelvin. Boiling point is 77.2 Kelvin. Now let us discuss about the chemical properties of nitrogen. You already studied that the nitrogen has a triple bond. The bond length is 109.8 picometer, that is very less. Bond dissociation energy is very high, that is 941.4 kilojoule per mole. Due to these properties, that is triple bond, low bond length and high dissociation energy, nitrogen is highly inert. Not only that, nitrogen is not very high electronegativity when compared to oxygen and fluorine. So, it is not very good oxidizing agent as that of oxygen and fluorine. Nitrogen also is not very high electropositive like metals. Therefore, it is not a good reducing agent when compared to metals. At high temperatures, nitrogen reacts with certain metals and non-metals. Now let us discuss the reactions of nitrogen with metals. Nitrogen reacts with highly electropositive elements when these metals are burnt in atmospheric nitrogen. So, when lithium is burnt in nitrogen, we get lithium nitride. When sodium is burnt in the atmosphere of nitrogen, we get sodium nitride. When calcium is burnt in nitrogen, we get calcium nitride. Magnesium is burnt in nitrogen, we get magnesium nitride. Now, let us discuss the reactions of nitrogen with non-metals. Ammonia by Haber process and nitric oxide. In Haber process, nitrogen and hydrogen gases are made to react at special conditions, like by using finely divided iron as catalyst, molybdenum as a promoter. Promoter means which increases the activity of a catalyst. At 750 Kelvin temperature and atmospheric pressure ranges from 200 to 900 and we get ammonia. And this process is known as a Haber process. And of course, commercially ammonia is manufactured in this process. Nitrogen reacts with oxygen at a very high temperature, that is nearly 300 Kelvin, and in the presence of electric arc, we get nitric oxide. This nitric oxide can be further reacted in the process of manufacture of nitric acid. Because of this highly inertness of nitrogen, though nitrogen and oxygen are present in atmosphere, they do not react with each other, due to which the life is sustained. Reactions of nitrogen with compounds. Nitrogen combines with alumina in the presence of carbon at very high temperature and we get aluminium nitride and of course carbon monoxide. Similarly, calcium carbide reacts with nitrogen at 1300 Kelvin, we get calcium cyanamide, CaNCN. Uses of nitrogen. Nitrogen is used in the manufacture of ammonia, and ammonia is largely used in the manufacture of fertilizers like ammonium sulfate, diammonium phosphate, urea, etc. And other nitrogen is also used in the manufacture of industrial compounds like calcium cyanamide. We studied that nitrogen is highly inert. The inert nature of nitrogen is used in carrying certain chemical reactions. That means, in the presence of nitrogen, inert atmosphere is created, which is required for carrying out of chemical reactions. Liquid nitrogen is used as a refrigerant in preserving biological materials in freezing foodstuffs. You might have seen in the news that sometimes the body parts from brain dead patients, the body parts like eyes, heart, kidneys, etc., they are removed, and of course they are transplanted to patients who are in need. So here it is to understood that the brain dead patient may be in one area, and of course the patient for whom the transplantation is required, he or she may be in another city or another area. So while transporting these body parts like kidneys, cornea, heart, etc., they are preserved in liquid nitrogen and transported, and of course they are transplanted to such required patients. So that is the purpose of liquid nitrogen. Nitrogen is used in gas-filled mercury thermometers used in measuring very high temperatures. So these are the uses of nitrogen. Laboratory method of preparation of ammonia. We studied about the structure of ammonia in the previous class, that is while discussing the hydrides of group 15th element, and this is the central nitrogen atom. It has three NH bonds, and of course apart from this it has lone pair. So the presence of lone pair plays an important role in deciding the properties of ammonia. Ammonia has a lone pair of electrons. The lone pair can be donated to atoms having empty orbitals. Lone pair donors are called Lewis bases. Thus, ammonia is Lewis base. Preparation of ammonia, let us discuss now. Ammonia can be prepared by heating ammonium salts with strong bases. Ammonium sulfate is heated with sodium hydroxide at high temperature, and we get ammonia. Apart from this, we get sodium sulfate and water. Ammonia can also be prepared by heating a mixture of ammonium chloride and caustic potash at high temperature. We get ammonia gas. Preparation of ammonia by the action of water on metal nitrides. Aluminium nitride is treated with water. We get aluminium hydroxide and ammonia. Magnesium nitride is treated with water. We get ammonia and magnesium nitride. Now let us see the schematic diagram showing the preparation of ammonia. See here, the mixture of reaction mixture is taken in a round bottomed flask and heated. And here this is a calcium oxide quicklime. This calcium oxide is used to remove the moisture present in ammonia gas. So here ammonia gas is lighter than air. Since it is lighter than air, the gas is collected by downward displacement of air. So this is gas jar. So the reaction mixture used here is ammonium chloride and calcium hydroxide, which is slaked lime. And ammonium hydroxide and slaked lime is heated. We get ammonia gas, calcium chloride and water. As we discussed already, ammonia is lighter than air, therefore it is collected by the downward displacement of air. The gas is passed over quicklime to remove the moisture. So such substances which remove the moisture from the gases are referred as drying agents. So quicklime is a drying agent. Ammonia gas cannot be collected over water because it is highly soluble in water. 1 liter of water can dissolve nearly 1000 liters of ammonia. That's why it is collected by downward displacement of air, but not through water. Now let us see the manufacture of ammonia by Haber process. According to Lee-Chatelier principle, favorable conditions for forward reaction are low temperature and high pressure. A mixture of ammonia, nitrogen and hydrogen gases is heated to 750 Kelvin and of course pressure ranging from 200 to 900 atmospheric pressure. In the presence of finely divided iron as catalyst and molybdenum as a promoter, we get ammonia. Here, delta H formation, enthalpy of formation is -46.1 kilojoule per mole. At a low temperature, the reaction is very slow. Because of that, the optimum temperature, that is, the exactly required temperature is temperature of 750 Kelvin is maintained. Finely divided powder is used as catalyst as we discussed at the above reaction. To increase the rate of the reaction, we know that catalyst alters the rate of the reaction. Here, this is catalyst increases the rate. Molybdenum is used as promoter, which increases the activity of catalyst. Now here this is the flow chart. The mixture of hydrogen and nitrogen are passed through a compressor where high pressure is applied and it is passed here through the catalyst chamber. Apart from iron oxide, aluminum oxide and potassium oxide can also be used as catalyst. So here reaction takes place and ammonia we get. This ammonia thus obtained is collected over water. This is industrial preparation, remember. The ammonia so produced is used in further reactions in the manufacture of fertilizers, etc. So here we get ammonium hydroxide. Under these favorable conditions also, the yield is very less. Therefore, the unreacted gases, that is nitrogen and hydrogen, again passed through the pump and of course it circulates. It is recirculated through the plant so that the reactants are not wasted. Flow chart for the manufacture of ammonia. See here, nitrogen and if this is a little more detailed drawn. The mixture of ammonia and nitrogen and hydrogen is taken in the ratio of 1:3. It is passed through compressor where the pressure ranges from 200 to 900 atmospheric pressures. And the gases are passed through soda lime chamber. Soda lime is nothing but sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide. The purpose of this soda lime is to remove the moisture and carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide reacts with calcium oxide to form calcium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide removes the moisture. It is highly deliquescent substance, sodium hydroxide. Deliquescent substances are those which can absorb moisture and become saturated solutions. So, the gases free from moisture and carbon dioxide are passed through preheater chamber where the temperature is maintained at 750 Kelvin. From preheater chamber, it is the mixture of gases passed through catalyst chamber. From catalyst chamber, the mixture is passed through heat exchanger where it cools down. The gases are cooled by sudden expansion through a small hole. So here from catalyst chamber, when the gases come from catalyst chamber to heat exchanger, some of the ammonia is formed. So when the gases are released, therefore sudden expansion takes place. Because of the sudden expansion, it needs a heat for expanding, therefore ammonia gets liquefied. Unreacted gases, nitrogen and hydrogen are recirculated through the plant as we discussed in the previous slide. Physical properties of ammonia. Ammonia is lighter as we discussed. The density is 0.68 gram per centimeter cube. It is colorless with a strong pungent smell. Ammonia is extremely soluble in water. we discussed already that 1 liter of water can dissolve 1000 liters of ammonia. Ammonia gets liquefied on cooling under pressure. That is, boiling point of ammonia is 239.6 Kelvin, freezing point 202 Kelvin. On evaporation, liquid ammonia causes cooling effect. Now let us discuss the chemical properties of ammonia. Basic nature. Aqueous solution of ammonia is a basic in nature and it turns red litmus. Then what is a characteristic property that decides the basic nature? It is hydroxide ion. So here, when ammonia dissolves in water, we get ammonium ion and hydroxide ion. The basic nature is due to the release of hydroxide ion in the presence of water or moisture. This is ammonium ion and hydroxide ion. Formation of ammonium properties. We are discussing chemical properties, and the second property of ammonia is formation of ammonium salts when it reacts with acids like hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, etc. So ammonia reacts with hydrochloric acid to form ammonium chloride. Ammonia reacts with sulfuric acid and we get ammonium sulfate. When ammonia reacts with aqueous solutions of salts, their metals are precipitated. For example, when ammonia gas is passed through ferric chloride or aqueous solution of ferric chloride and ammonium hydroxide are mixed, we get brown precipitate of ferrous hydroxide. Brown precipitate of ferric hydroxide and of course ammonium chloride is formed. Aluminium chloride. When ammonia gas is passed through aqueous aluminium chloride solution, we get aluminium hydroxide, which is a white precipitate, and of course ammonium chloride. Chromium chloride. When ammonia gas is passed through chromium chloride solution, we get chromium hydroxide, and this is the green precipitate. When ammonia gas is passed through zinc sulfate solution, we get white precipitate of zinc hydroxide. All these reactions are used in salt analysis. You have a practical class also in salt analysis. In salt analysis, identification of metal ion, we use this ammonia gas. Complex formation. You will study about the coordination compounds in the next chapter. You know that ammonia has its central atom is nitrogen, and nitrogen has a lone pair. This lone pair can be donated to those atoms which are in need of a lone pair or which have an empty orbital. So a coordinate covalent bond is formed. When this coordinate covalent bond is formed between a metal ion and of course ammonia, such compounds are called complex compounds. Therefore, this is complex formation. When ammonia gas is passed through aqueous solution of silver salt, say silver chloride, we get diammonium silver plus ion. The name of this ion is diammonium. Two ammonia molecules are there. And these, the lone pairs present in nitrogen atom are donated to empty d orbitals of silver. Therefore, we get a complex compound. The complex compound is denoted in square brackets. And of course, this is positive ion. Diammonium silver one ion. Also, ammonia combines with aqueous solution of copper salt. We get tetraamine copper 2 plus ion. Tetraamine copper 2 ion. CuNH3 taken 4 times 2 plus. Similarly, when it combines with cadmium, we get Tetramine cadmium ion. Tetramine cadmium ion. Now let us see the uses of ammonia. Ammonia is used to produce various nitrogenous fertilizers like NH4NO3, urea, NH2CO, NH2, ammonium phosphate, ammonium sulfate. This already we discussed in the reactions of ammonia with acids. So all these substances are used as fertilizers. Ammonia is also used in the manufacture of some inorganic nitrogenous compounds like nitric acid and tests for ammonia. How can we identify ammonia? First of all, ammonia can be identified due to its characteristic pungent smell. It turns turmeric paper brown. Ammonia gives brown precipitate with Nessler's reagent. Nessler's reagent is K2HgI4. Ammonia gives dense white fumes with a drop of HCl. While ammonia is prepared, just you keep a glass rod dipped in hydrochloric acid near the mouth of the flask where ammonia gas comes out. It gives dense white fumes. And of course, this reaction is used in salt analysis also. Ammonia gives a deep blue solution with copper sulfate solution due to the formation of a complex, that is tetramine copper sulfate. This we discussed just in the previous slide. So we discuss remaining, that is nitric acid and its reactions, in the next class. Thank you.